John and Harold, you're here in this moment right here, and I want you to just look around and take all the faces in. These people are here because they love you. Do you love them?
Yeah.
They do. They're here because they love you, and they're here to support you as you make one of the biggest decisions of your life. And today we're going to witness something beautiful and something amazing, the moment that you two are wed together.
When I walked into your garage and asked about my son attending a birthday party, me, the unsociable one who never got to know his neighbors. I mean, our boys must have only been 5 or 6 at the time. I remember your hair was in a little bob, just hanging over your shoulders. And another few years pass, and I walk into more Avance. And I turn to see you smile. I know you say it was just a smile, but it wasn't. It was a moment.
I can't begin to tell you how grateful I am that you claimed my smile before I ever knew that it was yours. Thank you for loving my chaos, whether it's my loud family, my interesting friends, my extra personality, my chatty, sometimes dramatic son. We sure brought a lot of noise into your quiet world. Thank you for loving me on my darkest days. You truly are the calm in my storm. And babe, thank you for waiting for me. I promise to make it worth it. I will love the father that loves fiercely, the brother that loves protectively, and the son that loves selflessly. I promise to be your biggest cheerleader because I believe in you and all of your aspirations. I promise to tell you and show you every day that I love you, even on the days that we are tougher to love. I promise to challenge you, frustrate you, and fuss with you, not only because I'm stubborn, but because it makes us better, and I will fight forever to be with you.
Love takes pleasure in the flowering of truth. Love puts up with anything. It trusts God always. It always looks for the best. And it never looks back, but keeps going to the end. Love never dies. Trust steadily in God. Hope unswervingly. Love extravagantly. And the best of these three is love. The most intimate illustration that the Bible uses to demonstrate His relationship and love with us is a bride and a groom. And today you're illustrating the beauty of God's love as you pronounce your love for each other. Now, Harold and Jeanne have decided to plant a unity tree as a symbol of the commitment they are making together today. This tree will be at their home as a constant reminder of all the people that contributed to their lives and their relationships. In the presence of these many witnesses, let no one ever separate what God Himself has joined here together. Harold, you may kiss your bride. It is with great honor and pleasure that I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Harold Weiss. Come on.
I did marry you.
We're gonna have a funky good time. 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 Let's take them up, friend.
At this moment, we will bring forth the lovely bride and groom for the evening, Mr. and Mrs. Harold.
You have made me a better person because with you, I am authentically me. You make me the best version of myself. You are my home, Harold Paul Weiss Jr. I love you more than you can possibly imagine, and I can't wait to meet you at the altar and start forever with you. At last, on my love, Jeanne.
Stand next to our pastor and friends and pledge my love to you for the rest of our lives. I love telling you I love you, but I cannot wait to tell you I do.